A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th December, on the front page you have 43 dead, 16 injured in major Delhi fire. So here you can see at least 43 people, including minors, have been feared dead and over 16 have been injured after a major fire broke out in a residential building being used as a manufacturing unit in Anaj Mandi area in central Delhi. And here you have regarding citizenship bill, which we have already discussed. So there is opposition to citizenship bill. Then on page 5 you have Rajasthan Tourism Minister demands ban on Panipat. So Rajasthan Tourism Minister is demanding a ban on screening of Ashutosh Gawalkar's Panipat in North India to avoid a law and order situation following protests against the film in Bharatpur. So it is claimed that Maharaja Surajmal of Bharatpur has been shown in bad light in the On page 8 you have delay in NREGS wages hits BPL families. So the alleged delay by the center in releasing the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme wage and material cost errors of 1000 crores due to Kerala and has left about 15 lakh below poverty line families in lurch. So here you can see errors comprise of wages of 860 crores and material cost and administrative expenses of 140 crores. So payment of wages has been indefinitely held up at a time when state is trying to overcome the pangs of rural poverty, price hike of essentials, job loss due to economic slowdown and such other major hits. And about 95% of the workers registered under NREGS are women. So it is pushing them on the verge of poverty. So central government releases NREGS wages to various states, but here this is a coverage on how in Kerala wages have not reached the beneficiaries. And below you have Telangana town to host bird walk festival. So a two-day event around Kumaran Bhim will be showcasing avian wealth in Telangana. So here you can see Kumaran Bhim in Asifabad district of Telangana is all set to earn the distinction of being the first in the state to organize a bird walk festival. On page 9 you have the coverage on the front page news regarding the fire. And here you have panel pulls up 19 states for tire disposal. So this is Central Pollution Control Board, which has pulled up 270 tire pyrolysis units in 19 states for employing technology that is polluting and harmful to the health of the workers employed. So you can see tire pyrolysis refers to technique of breaking down used tires in the absence of oxygen. So shredded tires at temperature between 250 and 500 degrees Celsius produce liquid, oil and gas. The breaking down of the tire. But while this is considered a safer technique than burning tires, pyrolysis leaves fine carbon matter, pyrogas and oil as residue, and inadequate management of these byproducts pose health risks. And this is CVC summons EPFO top brass after fire. So Central Vigilance Commission has summoned the top brass of Employee Provident Fund organization after a fire destroyed its vigilance wing office in the capital, in Delhi. And this is in 5 years, 27 students across 10 IITs took their own lives. So IIT Madras has seen the highest number of suicides as such during this period, according to this RTI report. On editorial page, the first editorial is Trampling on Grassroots. So this is regarding the local body elections that have been delayed by 3 years in Tamil Nadu. So it is called, it's a travesty of law that local body polls have been delayed. So you can see. So this is, it has, Tamil Nadu will witness elections now in the last week of this month, but it has been delayed by 3 years, which is a cause of concern. And this is shooting in Pensacola. So this is regarding Florida's Pensacola Naval Air Station. So the deadly shooting here by Saudi aviation student has killed 3 and injured 8 others and this is called to be a fresh challenge to the Saudi authorities, who are trying to remake the kingdom's image after a series of recent setbacks. US federal investigators are yet to establish the gunman's motive, but the gunman was from Saudi Arabia. Then the lead article is, constitutional justice is non-negotiable. So it says the ends of justice are not served by wanton killing and retributive bloodlust. India must follow constitutional morality. So this is in the context of the Disha rape and murder case, in which all four accused have been killed in encounter. But justice should not come through this manner, not a retributive justice. It should be constitutional justice. There is no other way. And this is an ancient engine driven by India and China. So this is regarding Asia's rise and how it is linked to peace and stability and cooperation. And it says cooperation rests on compact between the two countries. So India and China should cooperate, which makes in Asia move ahead across the globe. On op-ed page you have, demonizing the legal system won't help. So some of the existing laws are already too harsh and some other provisions are not being implemented. So problem is not with the legal system and laws are already harsh. What is required is swift implementation and swift justice. In the sense, the pendency of cases have to be looked at. On page 12, you have, 6 years on, Lokpal is yet to get prosecution hearing. So almost 6 years after Lokpal and Lokayukta Act 2013 has been signed into law, several key provisions needed for anti-corruption ombudsman to function have still not been operationalized. So the process of constituting Lokpal's inquiry and prosecution wings has not yet begun. And the regulations for how to conduct preliminary investigations have not been made. So Lokpal is lacking teeth. So this is what has come forth through an RTI inquiry. And below you have, Pramila tables resolution in US House on Kashmir. So this is a bipartisan resolution which calls for end to restrictions in Kashmir and for India to respect international human rights law. So this is Pramila Jayapal, who has tabled this bill. This bill has been tabled in the US Congress, US House of Representatives. On page 13, you have, PM asks police to connect with public. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has asked the top police officials of the country to use social media effectively and promote the good work done by the force. So the address at the annual All India Conference of DGs and IGPs, Director Generals and Inspector Generals of Police, was organized by the Intelligence Bureau in Pune. Then on international page you have, Hong Kong marks 6 months of protests. So organizers say 8 lakh joined rally, which was biggest since recent elections. The police has arrested 11 people and seized weapons. And this is, FBI presumes shooting at US naval base was an act of terror. So on social media, he has charged the accused, Muhammad Ashamrani. He has charged the Americans as anti-Muslims. Then this is Sukir Gamble's reputation in Rohingya case. So, Organization of Islamic Countries will call on the International Court of Justice to announce steps to restrain Myanmar in Rohingya case. So, Aung San Suu Kyi is the leader in Myanmar, of the political party which is in power. But she is a Nobel Peace Prize winner too. But here now, the case of Rohingyas puts her reputation at stake. And this is, Iran hopes to use Russian funds to counter US sanctions. So budget of resistance with $5 billion from Moscow is in the works. And this is how Iran is planning to counter US sanctions. So these are the important headlines. The business page does not have coverage on macroeconomics. It's money-wise data which is covered here on Mondays, and the last page has sports related news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.